Round of applause.
Hi, I'm very excited to be here, and good morning to all you folks. How are we doing today? Everybody is up with enough caffeine in them? Everybody's awake? All right. So let's get started with today's topic. Julia was just talking about the importance of just understanding how term counts could help us in understanding what data, the corpus is composed of, like how are the words contributing to the corpus. So what else can we do about it? So in this talk, we're going to be exploring and understanding ways to understand the word relevance when we are exploring and evaluating text data set. But why do we need to do this? We all here like to make, build predictive models. It's fun and exciting, right? So as you can see, predictions, they often go wrong. So when that happens, we are often faced with the problem, what do we do next? Because a lot of the times, this machine learning and predictive models are black boxes. So with that, let me introduce myself again. So I'm a data scientist at datascience.com. And often I've been exploring better ways to evaluate this black box machine learning algorithm so that we could enable model evaluation and interpretation, not only for the experts, but also for the non-experts. We also host a meetup down in LA called PyData SoCal, so if you guys are down in LA, please do stop by. So let's start with defining the scope of interpretation with respect to text data set. We're going to be defining interpretation globally, which means we want to study the dependence of our variables with the target value, considering the whole corpus. At the same time, we also want to evaluate a single prediction. So we want to understand, not only do we want to understand how all the features are contributing to the corpus, but we also want to understand how a single prediction is actually behaving and what are the features which are contributing to the success or failure of a single prediction. One other thing, since this domain is pretty wide, for today's topic, we're going to be restricting ourselves to supervised learning problems. Everybody in the room is aware of supervised learning problems, right? Cool. So with that, let me introduce you to our effort that is going down at datascience.com, and we recently open sourced a project called Scalers. And the purpose is to enable such model evaluation, model interpretation techniques for experts and non-experts in a very convenient way. So, going back to the last topic that we were discussing, TF-IDF. When we get a text corpus, the first thing that we do is that we're faced with this raw text, which is character-based. To make a machine learning algorithm work, we have to do some transformation. As Julia correctly mentioned, TF-IDF is a very common transformer that we typically use. Why is it popular? One, because not only does it count the number of terms in the document, but it also normalizes on the relevance or importance of that particular term in the complete corpus. So that's why we define term frequency as TF-IDF as the dot product of term frequency and its importance, inverse importance in the document. So once we have created this TF-IDF, it looks like a matrix, right, that we see here, where the row will have the words, the individual rows is the text document, and that is, the columns are the individual words, and they'll have some weights associated to it. Now, these weights are very important, and they might be able to convey us a lot of information, but how do we query for this information? One, we can query for this information at the corpus level. That is considering the whole data set. So Scalar provides some ways to query for the top features which are contributing in the whole corpus. We also want to understand what are the top key features with respect to each class. Okay, so we also provide a convenient way to query for top features with respect to each categorization class. That's good. We also want to understand what are the top features for an individual document as well? Cool. So we provide a way to query for top features at the document level as well. So if you can see, we are moving from the global to a local level in a very consistent way. Okay, we talked about DFIDF, what else can we do? How about we visualize the same level of interpretation moving from doc to class to overall data set in a much interpretable way. So word clouds are pretty famous. And what SCADA has done is it has allowed a convenient way to create word clouds at all different levels. So what I'm showing here is the one on the left is at the document level, the one in the middle is at the class, and the one at the rightmost is at the overall level. So moving ahead, what else can we do? So all this is good. But most often not, when we are evaluating text, the complexity of the problem is quite a lot. One, we may be faced with a huge amount of data set, and we want to understand how each document is actually contributing to the success or failure of a particular model. So far, we are still in the phase where we're dealing with the transformed data. So all we have done is we have taken the raw corpus and we have converted them into some numerical feature. And all we are talking about right now, till now, is different ways to actually evaluate and understand what are the top features which are contributing. So SCADA also provides a way to visualize them with respect to coloring the words based on the weight gradient and highlighting it at the document level. So the ones which are dark blue, like ball and base. So this data set, the target label is for baseball, and as you can see, like base and ball, they have a lot of weight on it, so that's why they're kind of dark blue. And the ones in yellow are which are not considered. So that's again an important point. So when we create DFIDF for dealing with text, we need to take care of the stock words or the words which occur very often, like, you know, is the same, which are like unnecessary words. We want to get rid of that. In doing our understanding and visualizing this way, it helps us understand or gain confidence that the transformer is actually behaving the way we want. Now this is very important because soon we're going to be scaling out. So maybe you started your experiment on a small corpus, but now you want to extend it to a big data set. And being confident early on helps, it helps in being very methodical when dealing with the big data sets. So now let's jump a couple of steps and talk about a more complex algorithm. So far we talked about transformation. Now, what if we have built a model? How do we go about evaluating it? So there is recently, back in some of his folks, they published a paper on a technique called layer-wise relevance propagation. What we're showing on this slide is a simple one-layer neural network, and we can see that, say, these are all the same, your inputs, 1, 2, 3, each input has this weight associated with it, and the weight gets transferred to this first layer in a neural network. When that happens, what I meant is that the weights are propagated in a forward manner from the input layer to the hidden layer to the output layer finally. So at this layer, we have the weights which comprises to all the inputs that were fed in. Can we reverse it? Looks like we can. And if we do, what information can we gain? So now think that in the final layer, you have access to all the features and the weights associated to it, right? Now what you want to understand is, can these weights correspond to the features that we started with? Why do we need to do it, and why it's a little complex problem is because different layers of a neural network, it understands different aspects of the feature, right? We go from shallow to the deeper model where we are understanding minute features, and then we started understanding more structured features. This becomes very important because now we're talking about ways to evaluate non-linear classifiers. Okay? So let's stick with that idea. So let's simplify the problem a little bit. So for today, let's focus on more simple linear problems. So everybody in the room has an idea how to define a linear estimator. So we have a vibe, we define an intercept, which is a bias, some weights, and then the feature set, right? So this W, that's the weight, is very important. Okay, can we apply or simplify the layer-wise relevance propagation to a linear classifier? Looks like we can. So we talked about TFID of weights, right? Let's think that those TFID of weights are the weights that we would have, we might have learned in a single layer neural network. Can we map it to the weights that the estimator has actually learned, and then understand how the features are actually contributing to the success or the failure of a particular prediction? So Skater currently supports a simplified form of linear propagation, a linear relevance propagation, which works for linear classifier. And what can we do with that? Now with that, we can again evaluate how the predictions are doing at the document level. So in this one, the gold label for this particular, So for this experiment, I used the famous 20 news group dataset. It's a pretty famous dataset. The training set is not, I mean, the dataset is not that big. It's like 20,000 rows which are there, and the categorization is across 20 categories. That's why the 20 news group dataset is typically called. So in that, one of the categories, motorcycles, and other categories, autos. So in this, we see the gold level label is actually motorcycle, but the predicted is autos. So now again, with the help of this visualization and document label, we can highlight what the important words are and the ones which are actually not contributing to the success or failure of the model. So the ones in red are the ones which are falsely classified or not contributing. Same we can do it at, so this is again, what if we just use the default weights? We can do a similar experiment. So we talked about layer-wise propagation. So let's make or increase the complexity a little bit more. What if we have non-linear models as well? In that, we don't have access to the weight. So we need some other form or other technique to actually evaluate it. What if we define the loss function or our optimization function as some generic foo, where we pass in the base estimator, doesn't matter whether it is linear or not, and summarize it with the more convenient linear estimators, like linear regression, logistic regression, decision trees, such forms, where we have access to the coefficients. If we do that, then again, we have access to evaluate the documents, again, at the global level or for individual prediction as well. So this is for individual prediction, where we're trying to identify how or what are the features, top two features, which are actually contributing to the success or failure of a model. Another complexity is, what if not a lot of the times we build models ourselves, at times we use third-party models, and at that time we're faced with the same problem. How do we evaluate whether this model is genuine or not? Again, it's a confidence issue. So with Skater, we have the ability to support deployed models as well. So if you're using a third-party model from a marketplace, Indico or Algorithmia, we can evaluate them consistently again. So in this experiment, we are evaluating and comparing Indico and Algorithmia, and doing sentiment analysis and understanding which model is better. So with that, I would also like to extend a special thanks to some of my colleagues, Aaron and Ren, and then TechXT and BIDS to invite us and give us an opportunity to share our thoughts. So quickly, let's summarize. So why model interpretation or evaluation better techniques are important is that as you're building these sophisticated predictive models, it's not only really important to just understand what features are there at the global level. We have to understand why did the model behave in a certain way? What information can a model provide to identify a false classification? And how can we enable trust on this black box? Only by answering why, what, and how can we enable better model performance. So yeah, with that, open to Q&A. All right.